just like a lot of Oklahomans last night, the zoo had a little experience with the weather in that a big water surge and debris surge adjacent to our Red Wolf exhibit caused a little breach in our containment.
So what happened? Did some animals get out?
We did have one get out, yes.
What's the status?
And we're confirming the status of the other one right now. That the one that got out was found as per our protocols by our security staff, and we were easily able to acquire this one. And it's let me be specific here. It's a red wolf, which is a little larger than a coyote. They're pretty shy, elusive animals. If you've been to the zoo, you've probably seen our red wolves either early in your visit or later in your visit because they kind of hunker down midday.
And are they? Is the wolf okay? Or
the wolf?
Okay?
Yes, the wolf is fine. Too.
Okay. Was there any threat to anyone in the park or the staff or anything like that?
No, the zoo was closed at the time. Again, we have 24-hour security that, especially after a storm like this, just as you would at home, goes around and checks everything, all the perimeters of our exhibits.
When did y'all realize, at what point last night, that there was a problem, that there had been some type of breach with the flooding?
It was early this morning. I think it may have been the rain throughout the night that caused the issue.
And then how long did it take y'all, once you realized there was an issue, to then catch the wolf?
It was pretty quick, actually. I mean, we have a timeline from our security folks, which kind of outlined their first observation and sequestering the wolf into one of the areas behind the Big Rivers Cafe.
And then with the damage, have you closed that part of the park, or, you know, how has the weather impacted operations today?
We do have Oklahoma Trails closed off this morning as we further assess that area.
Was the wolf in the Oklahoma Trails area? Is it a native Oklahoman?
Yes. The red wolf is a part of our Oklahoma Trails exhibit, and yeah, is a native Oklahoman species or historic Oklahoman species. So yeah, it was found adjacent to its exhibit.
Do you think it was used to this weather?
As much as the rest of us, yeah. It's pretty enriching.
So, and you were kind of saying it's kind of a shy, elusive animal, so it's not really a scary, dangerous situation. I mean, obviously you want to get it.
Certainly, just like any animal, if it's cornered, there's a potential risk, but this is not an aggressive animal. It's a very shy, elusive species.
Another thing you guys might want to know about is that, because I know back at the office, particularly at the Oklahoman, we have policies and protocols that we follow year-round. We have drills. We just had a drill for a code yellow, you might want to explain what. If you want to explain that, but this is, we practice this stuff in the event that we have any potential for, you know, lost child, bound child, tornadoes, animals that may have breached their enclosure, that sort of thing.
Certainly. Yeah, we go through regular drills, training on escape procedures for both our dangerous animals and our perhaps less dangerous animals, as with the red wolf. So we've got procedures in place. We've got staff that have certain roles. Certainly animal care staff and our veterinary staff have significant roles associated with